हरिओम स्वामी जी। आर वी ऑडिबल स्वामी जी? यू आर ऑन म्यूट स्वामी जी।
इज इट फाइन नाउ?
यस स्वामी जी। हरिओम स्वामी जी।
हरिओम मां, नमस्ते।
नमस्ते वन एंड ऑल। Today, under EPG Patashala and Consortium for Educational Communication under the Faculty of Yoga Sciences and Therapy, Meenakshi Academy of Higher Education and Research, the webinar today is handled by Swami Shivarishi ji, and the topic for the webinar is Who is a Yogi? Over to you, Swami ji. Hari Om.
Namaste to one and all present here. Let us start with a small prayer. I will take you through a short guided meditation, followed by a chanting which you will listen and repeat after me. Please sit straight. Please sit with your back, neck and head in a nice straight line. Gently close your eyes. Become aware of the whole physical body from the top of the head to the tip of the toes. Make yourself comfortable. Let the whole physical body become totally still and motionless like a statue. Become aware of the total, complete stillness and motionless. Become aware of the whole body from the top of the head to the tip of the toes. Intensify your awareness of total stillness. Now, mentally scan your body. From the top of the head to the toes. Mentally scan your body like a machine, a scan machine, scanning the whole body. Begin from the crown of the head. Gradually move your awareness to each and every part of the body, crown of the head, forehead, eyebrows, eyelids, eyes, cheeks, lips, chin, throat, collarbone, shoulder, chest, abdomen, pelvic floor, go on observing up to the feet, go on observing the whole body from the crown of the head to the tip of the toes. Your eyes are closed. Your body is totally still. Become aware of the total stillness and motionlessness of the body. Check whether you are having any pain or discomforts anywhere. Check whether you are having any uneasiness anywhere. Take a deep breath in, and as you breathe out, feel that the whole body is completely sinking down into the floor. Feel your shoulders, your arms becoming free from stiffness. Feel your legs sinking down into the floor. Feel the whole body becoming free of any stiffness. Feel the whole body becoming free of any tightness. Your eyes are closed. Your body is still. You are observing your body bit by bit, scanning it mentally, and keeping the whole body like a statue. Now, you may shift your awareness from the physical body to the natural breath. Intensify your awareness of your natural breath. Breath is flowing in and out on its own without any effort. Become aware of each and every breath as it flows in and as it flows out. The whole body should be like a statue. You are aware of the total stillness of the body, and you are aware of the movement of your breath. When breath comes in at the tip of the nose, you are able to feel chill air flowing into the nostrils. And when breath flows out, you are able to feel warm air flowing out of the nostrils. Observe 5 breaths from now. Next time, when your breath flows in, along with the incoming breath, please bring your awareness to your eyebrow center. At the eyebrow center, visualize a bright jyoti. Now, looking into the jyoti, we will chant the mantra Om together 3 times. Please breathe in deeply. I want you to please listen to the mantra that I am chanting and please repeat after me. Om Sahana Bhavatu Sahanau Bhunaktu Sahaviryam Karavavahai तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तो मा विद्विषावहै ओम शांति 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 ही हरि ही ओम Now leave the awareness of the jyoti that you are seeing in front of your closed eyes. Become once again aware of your breathing. Become aware of your physical body. Become aware of the room in which you are sitting, attending this webinar. Rub your palms against each other. Place the palms on the eyes. Feel the heat pass from the palm into the eyes. And gently open your eyes. I welcome all of you for my session on the topic that has been planned, who is a yogi? I would like to introduce myself to you. My name is Swami Shiva Rishi. I was also known as Jai Gopal. I founded the Satyananda Yoga Center in the year 2005. I have been a practitioner of yoga since 1988. My introduction to yoga happened through Shivananda Yoga Vedanta Center, founded by Swami Vishnu Devananda Saraswati, one of the foremost disciples of Sri Swami Shivananda. From 1988 to 1992, I underwent the basic training in the Shivananda system of yoga, which is an integrated approach to yoga. And then I went on to learn simplified Kundalini yoga from Vedatri Maharishi. I was one of the direct disciples initiated by him. And from 1993 to the year 2003, for about 11 years, under the guidance of the preceptors who were direct disciples of Vedatri Maharishi, I have had the opportunity to experience whatever he had planned to teach to interested people. From 2000 till now, I have been closely associated with the Bihar School of Yoga tradition. I got initiated into the Sannyasa order, and I was known as Sannyasi Shiva Rishi from 2005. And last year, on 22nd August, I have been named as Swami Shiva Rishi by my Guru, Paramahamsa Swami Niranjananda Saraswati. That's a brief introduction about my credentials and experiences with yoga. So today we are having this topic, who is a yogi? And I have conceived of two approaches to this topic. One is from a modern perspective, in today's perspective. Another is in the scriptural and the ancient perspective, where the scriptures provide us the definitions of how a person can be identified as a yogi. And I hope at the end of it, all of you will be able to receive some introductory inputs about these ideas, and hopefully you will be able to ponder over these ideas, which, if you seriously ponder over, can reorient your approach to yoga, reorient your approach to your own self. First of all, when we look at the yogic view of the self, from the philosophical angle, yoga views us not as this body. Yoga has four roots to it. Developed based on the Vedantic traditions. The Vedantic traditions do not accept the philosophy of yoga, but they look at yoga as a method for, a perfect method for integration of the personality, for fine-tuning the personality, and preparing the personality for spiritual initiation. Tantric background of yoga. The tantric background of yoga, which has been very effectively adopted by my Parama Guru, Swami Satyananda Saraswati, and the Yoga Nidra, which Sri Swami Satyananda developed, is practiced almost by everybody in the world. And the practice itself is based on the principles of Tantra. Tantra means, in a very simple language, trick. A trick through which you can escape from the entanglement that holds you ransom. So I have mentioned about the yogic background, the system of yoga developed based on yogic philosophy itself, the system of yoga that is developed based on Vedanta, the system of yoga that is developed based on Tantra, and the system of yoga that is based on bhakti. And we need to understand one basic thing. A person becomes a yogi by realizing the presence of a higher reality which governs over this whole cosmos, this whole creation, the manifest and unmanifest creation, the vyakta, avyakta prapanchas are governed by a higher order. Patanjali refers to this higher order as Ishvara. Narada refers to this higher order as Vishnu. The tantric scriptures refer to this higher order as Shiva and Shakti. Hatha Yoga refers to this higher order in the words Ha and Tha. So there is a higher order, a Devam, and a person who recognizes the presence of the higher order and intelligence, the wisdom that governs this entire creation, is an Astika. And a yogi is basically an Astika. He has clear understanding that there is the presence of this higher order, this greater intelligence, which is bigger than this entire creation, which is actually taking care of this whole universe and life. And the goal of yoga, according to the yoga philosophy, is oriented towards an inner life and not oriented towards an outer life. An inner life in which a person takes effort to merge the Jivatma with the Paramatma. Likewise, in Vedanta philosophy too, there is a recognition of the truth, which is the essence, which is the consciousness, which is the blemishless one. And in Vedanta, there is no movement or there is no merger of the jivatma with the paramatma, but there is a realization that the nature of the jivatma and the nature of the paramatma is one and the same, for which again there is an expectation that one should look more within first, not be completely extroverted. The point of emphasis that I'm trying to make when I'm beginning this talk is, as long as you are aiming to achieve something in this world, let it be a higher financial affordability, let it be fame, let it be better health and enjoyment of pleasures, whatever goal is oriented to the external world,